Our dearest beloved divine friends, brothers, sisters, family, in Guyana, around the world, in the raw. Our case, Guyana Free Media. And today is Wednesday, 5th of May, 2021. March it now, for the first time. This historic day in this country, recognized by the government of Guyana and even the previous government and the previous to that, that today is a major historical day in Guyana when our people, the people of Bharat, name change to India for whatever reason, and formerly also known as Hindustan, the land of science, philosophy, hundreds of religions, the land of peace, does not befriend nations to penetrate and overthrow them, as was done in many states in India by the Portuguese, the British, the Dutch, and even attempts by the Dutch to enslave our people by exporting them to Indonesia and other territory of theirs. And they like to brag that they were masters in trade. They and their Europeans were conquistadors, adventurers, conquerors, albeit thieves of peoples and nations. Having decimated Africa, carved it up, eat out the resources of Africa, from the human resource most of all, to the diamond, the gold, the zinc, the copper, the cobalt now, and the people, usually the best, the strongest, the most brilliant, put one set of kings to fight against another, or tribal leaders to overcome and to sell them into bondage, into abandonment across the waters for a life of perpetuity of servitude. Our African brothers and sisters, on this day of celebration of mine as an Indo-Guyanese and a descendant of the great land of Bharat, known as India, I salute the African ancestors who came before. But we all came in ships and we joined them. Who? The Africans taught us many things, ladies and gentlemen. This is the reality of acceptance. This is the reality of the brotherhood and love that exists between us over the last almost two centuries. They helped us when we arrived as midwives, as nurses, teaching us English, the ways of the white man, the colonial masters. Today I call for this goodwill and harmony and peace between our beloved African friends, family, brothers and sisters, and we all have some African in us, whether by intermarriage or friendship, whatever. Every one of us, somewhere along the line, someone has linked up with the African nation. And truly it shows that we are one human family in the dispensation of humanity, one human family under God. Dearest beloved divine friends and family, Today also is a day of reflections for all people. For we all came in ships, and that is why it's called Arrival Day. Not Indian Arrival Day, but Arrival Day to celebrate the Portuguese, the Chino or the Chinese, Guyanese ancestors, the Europeans even, and the Africans, friends and family. India, land of our ancestors, has always been one of the great traders of humanity. They traded to Saudi Arabia, to Mecca. They went into Mecca. They used to go to Mecca for the pilgrimage and did their worship. I don't forget that the Kaaba Sharif of Mecca, the Holy Kaaba, had over 300, near 400 idols in there. And we have evidence that the Indians and the Chinese used to come to trade, and that they, the Arabs, and our beloved prophet was also a trader, which is why he had so much knowledge, which many, much he got from the Creator, but much he got from his trading into the eastern lands. And I believe he went into China, and I believe he went into India. And he did say, if you want the wisdom and knowledge, you must prepare to go as far as China. And the yogic systems of exercise and the medical systems that he introduced, being a man of intellect and wisdom, and in his youth, always traveling, wise, with a brilliant mind from God Almighty, he was able to learn much. So India was in Mecca. India was in China. And from China took Buddha, an Indian, and made him their god. India traded with Vietnam and Cambodia. Today, Cambodia and Thailand are great historical nations of Hinduism. Cambodia, more than any, is considered the Hindu nation. Indonesia, where the Muslims abound, true trade, the wisdom of philosophy and religion went until today, even though 97% of the people are Muslims, or more, maybe 99%. They still have the ancient deities of thousands of years. And because of the revolution of time, God created humanity that is called the six periods of time. So when we are saying 5,000 years, 6,000 years, 3,000 years, it could be 3 million, it could be 300 million years. And still, in places like Indonesia, they pay obeisance to the ancient Hindu gods while they are Muslims, many of them. And they are discovering more and more relics of Indian worship and trade in Indonesia. Friends and families, I'm not trying to extol a religion here. I'm trying to extol the fact that India traded with all these countries, and it's proven that they came to North America and even into places like Chile and Peru. For the cultures and the methodologies of worship were so similar, and the sciences and the knowledge and the wisdom. So our people, our ancestors, are always people of peace. Also, we have facts of trade with Rome. Mighty Rome had to pay so much money to us. I always wonder why Rome never tried to conquer India with all the gold and the diamond that they used to buy from India, and the spices and the muslin cloth. Persia used to trade with India. Greece, ladies and gentlemen. The forms of gods and goddesses in Greece, and children of gods and wife of gods and gods with husbands, and gods of this and gods of that and gods of that, and the chief god with the demigods. All Indian principles, wisdom, and philosophies, my beloved divine friends and family. Our people came. Yes, they had some support, worse condition than the African slaves. And how our African brothers and sisters in ancient times suffered and laid their bones. But they were gracious. They were kind. They taught our people the truth about what to expect. And our people persevere. But our people are a people who are known to squeeze the bellies, tighten that knot, do with less to educate the children. They came for what, when you ask them? For a better life for our children to come. Because India was the richest and the wealthiest nation at that time around the world, when the British penetrated, manipulated, confiscated, stole hundreds of shiploads of gold and diamond and wealth out of India, and broke India and broke the wealth and caused famine. But, you know, I have to be fair, the British was by far the most humane of conquerors. The most humane in the sense that they allowed us to integrate and to socialize, unlike the Dutch. And that is why we lost our language, because we were allowed to integrate. We were taught English language. We were given a chance, yes, to maintain our religion or to join their religion, but they tried to teach us their way. We have to be somewhat fair to our colonial masters, while we suffered also at the hands of some of the owners of estates and so on. We were better off. That is why in Suriname, right next door, Suriname, ladies and gentlemen, where they had to stay in their community and be strong, they had to keep their language. They had to survive amongst only themselves, the Javanese, the Chinese. They had to survive amongst themselves. But we were given more freedom with religion and socialization and blending and a chance to develop and grow. Even in time, our people started to go into businesses and so on. But our people are truly a people of resilience. Indian people are not known to like to make war. But if you try to make war with them, they will take it for a while. Then they will go against you. And the Creator and universe and the Lord will create one or two or a few leaders to galvanize the people against tyranny. Friends and families, today I reflect upon my own ancestors. I have a mixture. I have a mixture of two great warrior clans, wisdom warriors. Wisdom warrior, saintly warrior. The Kshatriya of the Indian dispensation, the warrior clan, whom the business castes and the ruling and priestly castes tried to stay close to, because they were the warrior clan. They were big, they were tall. And they also, you started to have the Kshatriya kingdom being developed in India after a while. And then I have in me the Pathan clan. And you can see it in my body structure. You can see the Pathan clan and the Kshatriya clan. And for that I am grateful. A powerful DNA, a combination of power from the ancient land combined with the breeze and the earth and the products and the wind and the dew of beautiful Guyana, our home, all blended together to create me and you in Guyana, the Guyanese diaspora, and the Indian diaspora of Guyana who has gone around the world. Friends and families, today is a day of reflection, peace, harmony, live in love with all members of our societies, our communities. Never be aggressors. Always try to be defenders and protectors. And always try to share and invite and build tolerance and goodwill in a land of plenty to become much more plenty. I recognize the government of Guyana. I recognize great leaders within the government, previous leaders. I recognize the great leaders of the People's National Congress, men like Desmond Hoyt, Mr. Corbyn, even folks by Samson Burnham, recognize the greatness of the religions of our fathers, the greatness of the DNA of the Indian community, and the positivity they all recognize. While I have some problem with the current leadership, I pray that the universe and our country and our air will blow into their minds and hearts to open up and to work with all Guyanese for a better, a beautiful, a more wonderful Guyana. People of Indian descent in Guyana, and the whole Guyana, But you, the people of Indian descent, celebrate as you should in peace and joy and goodwill and love and respect for all, and share some of the goodies and the goodwill that you will have with your neighbors, regardless of religion, regardless of ethnicities. Let us build this beautiful love relationship of a great nation, of a great country that we all live in and breathe and eat from the earth, the fruits of resplendence. Happy May 5th, arrival day, dearest beloved Indian brothers and sisters of Guyana and all those who arrive. And a salute to the original peoples of Guyana, the indigenous, the what is referred to as the Amerindians, the indigenous, the original people. I salute them, for this was originally all theirs. And so we have to be pleasant and kind, considerate and supportive of our indigenous brothers and sisters. May the peace and may the mercies and may the blessings of the Creator and Lord be with our beloved country, Guyana. Your friend and brother, me, Hajji Dr. Roshan Khan, in the raw, saying thank you and farewell.